just to jump back again before I ask you this other question to George Brooks thing is that he's doing some interesting work working with some physicians at UCLA, I believe, with traumatic brain injury. So these are people that come in with like head gunshot wounds. So and they are looking at infusing lactate because he's the lactate guy.
Yeah.
But ketone bodies would work the same way.
I think it would work better.
If maybe
what we
even
know.
Better.
Yeah.
Right,
I think a cocktail of the two would be. And I've been debating whether or not to really study lactate sort of the same way I'm studying ketones and maybe make lactate esters or lactate and just to see what kind of results we see, starting with our oxygen toxicity model and then working from there, which is an excellent model.
Obviously, with the lactate, you have to have intact blood-brain barrier. No oxygen's getting there. You will get then lactic acid buildup, right?
Yeah.
Because then the mitochondria aren't going to be able to use the lactate, which is converted into pyruvate as energy, so it builds up. But he has been doing some work and looking at this glucose sparing in the brain, and so of course ketone bodies would work very similarly in theory.
Do you know how he gives? Does he use like a lactate? There's alpha L-poly lactate, I think. That's like in a sports supplement and some other things.
He actually designed. I think the one that he's got a patent on that.
I was using that back in 1991 and 2.
Cytomax,
right?
That's his. Yeah.
When I raced mountain bikes, that was like my go-to supplement.
He's
alpha L-poly lactate.
You should get in touch with George. He's great.
I know.
Yeah. So he. Let's see. What was I just going to say? I lost my train of thought.
The delivery or the.
Oh yeah.
The delivery.
That he's doing in this specific study. They're doing it intravenously. So.
Okay.
But. Yeah. I was mentioning the blood-brain barrier has to be intact, otherwise it can go the opposite way where it's actually bad for you. It would be really interesting to see, so the question is, one, well, does lactate or, beta-hydroxybutyrate or whatever, ketone get in through the MCT shuttle better? So there's questions of, which one gets in there and can they be used together and just all sorts of interesting things. Okay, so that was I'm sort of interested in this in my for my own personal
The neuroprotective capacity seems really compelling. I mean, from what we know about lactate, I'm approaching it going back to my old like PhD studies or whatever during hypoxia, but it would relate to so many traumatic brain injuries, hypoxia. So you're mitigating the damage.
And also traumatic brain injury is inducing damage, and so glutathione is one of the major ways of mitigating that. And there's been studies showing that early on it's important. If you get that early on, it prevents the whole cascade.
Yeah.
So I think that ketones and lactate both seem to have huge potential for glucose sparing.
Yep.
But that,
I think chilling the body and infusing ketones, lactate with a couple major few cofactors that are part of the bioenergetic use of these things would be a home run.
Yeah, get some students on it.
These are grants that I'm kind of working on and writing, but I'm not sure the funding agencies are ready to fully. They want like the magic pill thing,